Welcome back to Tangata Pasifika. Well, last week we introduced you to the beautiful Vava’u Islands in Tonga's north, yes. Widely regarded as the kingdom's number one tourist hotspot.
Yes, indeed. And we go back now to Vava’u, where there's plenty of sun, sand and surf to tempt the discerning visitor. It's what lies beneath the sea that's the real treasure. Soana K Aholelei has the story.
This might be just a small tropical town, but it has one of the world's biggest tourist attractions. All around Naiafu, you get a hint of just why tourists really come to Vava’u. So, it was only a matter of time before I got to head out on one of the whale-watching charters.
The whales we're looking for, they are humpback whales, and each year, from July through to November, they migrate up from Antarctica to the warmer areas. And the whole reason of this migration is purely for mating and breeding. These whales, they grow up to about 40 foot long, 2 kicks of the tails, and it raises 40 tons out of the water. It's very hard to miss that one. Pectoral strapping, their pectoral fin, it's almost a quarter of the full length of the whale.
Louis Charters. It's Tongan owned and it's run by brothers Lolisio, Norsa, and ex-rugby union professional Lata. Nicknamed the Whale Whisperers, these guys have been doing this since they left school.
My brother Norsa, he is the first person to swim with whales here in Tonga, and it's good to have him in the team. And my two younger brothers, Lata and Mika, just between us, we take turns and going out.
Over here, it's all deep channels right through these areas. That's why the whales really love coming, because it's like there's always a sheltered site on the island.
The main whale watching grounds are about 10k from the landing. There are about 16 charter boats operating here, but only one Tongan owned charter. Since Lolle started on his own back in 2013, he's never looked back.
It has been growing really fast. The number of tourists that is coming every year for whale watching is just growing, like keep breaking a record every year.
It's one thing getting here, but you've still got to wait. There's no rushing into the water.
If you come over here to do the whales, the more days you go out on the water, the better your chances. Because you're dealing with an absolutely wild animal, and you can only take what it gives you.
After a good 2 hours, Lolle is happy to let us get in. Okay, I've got my flippers on, I've got my snorkel gear on, and I'm about to get in the water with the beautiful humpback whales of Vava’u. So wish me luck. I have to let you in on a secret. I'm not a good swimmer. I'm petrified of the deep. So a bit of snorkeling in Swallow's Cave helped build my confidence. It also allowed the whales to get used to us.
Sometimes it's a little bit hard to approach them. We always give the whales distance and we wait for the whales to allow us to be with them. So it's just a lot of patience and just waiting for them to accept the fact that you want to be there with them.
And with them, I was. I had found Vava’u's treasures, and they were majestic. There are concerns swimming with whales could be harming them, but Lolle believes the rules here protect them.
It's very important that they keep the whale swimming law existing here in Tonga. I know the government of Tonga is really putting down their foot hard on rules and regulations on around the whales, and it's good.
Longer term, Lolle says more work is needed to strengthen the protection for whales in these waters.
I'm hoping that the government is gonna make Tonga a whale sanctuary, you know? It would be good to see Tonga go in this direction in the future somehow, you know? Trying to minimize bringing in foreign fishing vessels and things like that to try and preserve what is left over here at the moment regarding our marine life, because it's not just the whales, it's like the whole marine ecosystem of Tonga is massive. Our water space and water size here in Tonga is really massive. It would be great to see in the future that the Tongan government is like
putting in more effort to try and preserve this, because this is all we have.
Wow, beautiful.
I love the pictures.
Well, after the break, we meet the rising star in kickboxing, Rosales Ware.
I'm trying to defend my title of a world champ, so when I go over to Thailand, I'm trying to achieve back-to-back world titles.